Hey, this is Rella from Geekvine. And after DG 100 and 200, here we've got DG 300. So this is the newest generation of the DG model. And right now I've got the box. Alright, let's take a look at the phone. So there are two colors available, black and white. And this is the, well, it's more like dark blue, but to me it looks like black. So yeah, and alright, so it comes, so it was originally on the screen, I've taken it out, and it comes with a free little case, which is very, very nice. You can just, you know, change the back cover, just stick it on there, and you can see the screen through here, which is very nice and convenient. Alright, I'll do that later. So there's also another additional screen protector, the power adapter, earphone, and the USB and charging cable. Here is the user manual in English. Alright. So on this phone, it, if you can see here, it supports WCDMA 850 and 2100, as well as, so that's 3G, and 2G is GSM 850, 900, 1800, and 1900. So before you buy it, you can check if it's going to become compatible in your country. So for this phone, it, you know, it supports both 2G and 3G. So it's a plus for this. Okay, let me now turn the phone on. So the CPU is MTK6572W, and it is a dual core smartphone. Memory is 512 megabyte plus 4GB of ROM. Yeah, but it supports external micro SD card up to 22 gigabyte. Alright, before I do that, just wanna show you guys real quick the back of the phone. Ugh. It's a bit tight. Just need to use my nails. Over here. Yeah, so even though it's plastic, it's still pretty strong, as you can see. So it's dual SIM card supported. The first one is a regular or ordinary SIM card, and second one is a micro SIM card. So if you have either one of them, you have to worry about changing it. And here is for the micro SD card. This is the battery. Okay. Alright, so let's take a look. Yeah, so the phone has been working well for the past few days. I've been using it, and all right, let's take a look at AnTuTu. As always, okay. Here's the score, pretty good for a phone like this, and so it is the Android 4.2.2. operating system, dual core as mentioned previously. Screen resolution isn't too high, it's about 540x960. Two cameras, one in the back is 5 megapixel, and one in the front is 2 megapixel. Alright, we've covered memory, and frequency is up to 1.3 GHz, which is quite good, actually, for a dual core phone like this. Here are all the things that it supports and not supports. Okay, so right now we are selling this phone for $99.99, very close to $100, but it's, yeah, the price is pretty good. a very good deal for a smartphone like this, especially it is a 5-inch screen with IPS capacitive touchscreen, so it's quite good. I have my SIM card in there, so let's take a look at calling.
For English service, press.
Okay, so if I put it on speaker, it's actually quite loud. And okay, I've got some messages. Just want to show you guys settings if I can find it. Here. It always have a different icon and I have problem looking for it, finding it. Okay, all the standard Android settings. So it does have GPS, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, all that. So it supports many different languages. And up to like 6 English, 7 Englishes. Alright. And it comes with a couple apps like, you know, all those. And also as well as Google Play Store, so don't have to worry about that. And yeah, let's I just got this phone for a couple days and not very familiar with it. But I wanna know what the gallery is here. Here are some pictures. I've put it in the phone. So the color is quite nice actually, even though the screen resolution isn't too high. But you can still see the pictures pretty well. And especially with IPS screen, it's very nice. Very sensitive, you use it. Alright, let's check out videos. So it has very, very loud and clear sound, as well as graphics, it's pretty good. And I have downloaded an app where you can listen to music. It's a Chinese app. Wait, did I? Oh yeah. Okay. Alright, anyway, it doesn't look like Sound Play because it requires Wi-Fi. But yeah, I've used this app under where there is Wi-Fi, so it works pretty well. So sorry about that. Okay. Here's camera. Okay, it doesn't have touch focus. But that's okay. So there's a LED flashlight. Okay. Okay. Looks like the app still running. Okay. That's weird. Let's try it again. Alright, here we go. Yeah, so it looks like you can't really move immediately after you take the photo. Just need to hold for like a second more or two. Alright, let's try some games. What's this one? So this game requires pretty good 3D graphics as well as G-Sensor. So as you can see, the phone actually does pretty good when I play a game like this. Okay. Let's check out one more or two more. This is the Temple Run Destiny version of the game. So it's pretty fluent as I play the game. So that's a plus. Alright, not buying it. And what else? That's Plan with a Zombie that I've downloaded, but I'm not gonna play it right now. Let's just see one more game. So if you don't demand too high of you know, performance, I can't really tell like sometimes the difference between between dual core or you know quad core. So for a phone like this, that's you know less than $100, it's probably a really good choice if you don't have that high of a demand for you know like big games or screen resolution. So yeah, I would say it's a good choice if you wanna be a little, you know, save a lot of money. And yeah, please check it out. And I will see you next time. Bye.